Hey guys, what's up? It's Megan, and today's video is talking about how to raise your vibration. I'm gonna give you guys so many tips and tricks on how to get your vibration up, which will also help with your manifesting and getting all of your desires coming quickly and intentionally to you. So this is gonna be a fun video. We're gonna be outside. We're gonna be talking about ways to raise the vibration, and let's get started. Raise your vibration super quickly is called grounding. So grounding is the practice of taking off your shoes and putting your feet right there on the nice grass. And what this does is it connects your auric field with the auric field of the earth. And the earth has a strong magnetic field, and when you're connected to the earth, you are going to feel way more grounded. You're going to have a lot less anxiety, and this is actually scientifically proven to reduce inflammation in the body. As you can see, the Schumann resonance, having contact with the earth can reduce inflammation in this scientific study, as it shows. The inflammation goes down through your entire body, but just a few hours of just sitting on the grass or just standing on the grass. This does not work if you're wearing shoes, guys. So please remember to be barefoot, because what the shoes do is it's rubber and it breaks that. It doesn't have a conductive bottom to when you're standing outside on the grass, because rubber is obviously not conductive. All right, so ground yourself if you're raising your vibration. Also, the most lovely thing that you can do is be around flowers. The flower of life is actually something that is a sacred geometrical pattern, and flowers literally connect your resonance with the flower of life very quickly. Flowers are super high vibrational. Even like people in ancient Egypt used to eat flowers, and they would have blue lotus in their drinks because flowers are so high vibrational, and they connect you with your spirit. They connect you with your abilities, such as, like, you know, psychic abilities and other abilities that have been lost to us because as a community, as a society, we have, you know, dropped in vibration. Flowers are so intense. Like, just being around flowers completely raises my vibration. It's not because they look pretty, but it's literally because of the flower of life resonance. There's a cymatic geometrical pattern in every single flower, which is so dope, and it's also present in all of creation, but in the flower it can be more obvious to us. Another way to raise your vibration is to sun gaze, or to allow the sun's rays to get onto your pineal gland and to get inside of the cones and rods that are present in your pineal glands. So when you're sun gazing, you're going to activate those areas, and you're going to also steady your circadian rhythm. Sunshine in general is just extremely high vibrational because of the biophotonic light that is present in the sun. The sun will raise anyone's vibration. That's really why a lot of the times people get seasonal depression and things like that, because they're not getting enough sunshine. And when you're raising your vibration, you need to be out here looking at that sun. Don't obviously stare directly into the sun unless it is for sun gazing, which is at sunset and sunrise. And that raises up your vibration. Even just being out in nature. Please understand that nature is the most high vibrational thing, because it's never been corrupted, right? So any type of technology that man and humans make has the potential to be corrupted, but nature itself has not been corrupted. It still has the divine blueprint of our spirits. And when we're out in nature, we're picking up the auric field of all of the plants and trees around us, and that actually increases our auric field strength tenfold. It is also true that being around your friends and loved ones increases your vibration, because that increases your auric field, being around people that you love and care about. And that increases how intense and strong your auric field is just by being in 10 feet of them. Some people's auric fields can be 50 feet in diameter. And the bigger your auric field becomes, the more higher vibrational and the more powerful you become as a spiritual manifester and a human being in itself. All about raising and increasing your auric field of your aura, and increasing how far widespread your auric field goes out into the world, because that will raise other people's auric field vibrations as well if you're a high vibrational person. So why should you want a higher vibration? Things that are not desired by most people do not happen to people who are in a constant high vibration. And this is true with a lot of monks and how they actually can go to a state of not even feeling pain because of how much they increase their vibration. Your aura can be drained from so many different things, from energetic vampires to people who just are constantly, you know, to just being around people who have energetic entities on them, people who watch too much porn. And I've talked about this before. When you watch porn, you actually pick up etheric entities that are present in the auric fields of the actors, because sex is sexual, sacred energy exchange. So anytime you watch a sexual act or do a sexual act, you are having a sacred energetic exchange. And with porn, most of the time, these actors and actresses are not in the highest vibration themselves. And you're actually opening up your chakra system when you watch them on the screen to be connecting to them, and you're bringing in their auric field, and you're going to connect with their auric field. That's why a lot of times porn comes with, so of course, a lot of sex trafficking in porn, which I've talked about before, but that's spiritually the reason that porn is not okay, is because sex is, again, a sacred act that you should only be doing with someone who you want to be continuously connected to. People are awakening and they're waking up. So when you watch porn, you're creating an etheric cord. That's E-T-H-E-R-I-C, if you don't know how to spell it. And an etheric cord is something that creeps onto your aura. Basically, it's a hole in your aura, and it's a connection that you have to another person. And when you have an etheric cord tie to another person, you're basically connecting to that other person. Connecting to another person is a beautiful thing, and we should always honor connections. But if you're connecting to people on Pornhub.com or people who you don't know their own situation, then you're picking up their auric fields throughout your day and throughout your life. So if they get into a situation where they're angry or upset, the etheric cord tie is actually that bond that you're going to feel that anger and upsetness from that other person. Etheric soul ties happen anytime that you have sexual contact with someone, or even if you just have a very intimate and deep relationship with someone, you can create an etheric cord tie. So removing these etheric cord ties is extremely important too for a high vibration, because when you're with etheric cord ties with people who are depressed and suicidal, you might even start having the thoughts of that person who is suicidal, and that comes onto you. And that's what people do not realize, is that we are not just physical bodies, we have a spiritual aspect to ourselves. And people do not realize that etheric cord ties exist because they cannot see them. Okay? You can do things like auric cord cutting, which is basically going into the astral plane, cutting those cords. But anytime that you think about someone that you have an etheric cord tie with, you strengthen that etheric cord tie. So it's all about being wise and being mindful with your energy. If you wouldn't want to become that person, then I wouldn't put my sexual energy to that person. And that's facts and that's truth. So I hope you guys can understand that. Another thing that I want to bring up with becoming a more high vibrational person is probably one that's going to upset some people, or maybe feel like I'm just making this up, but being mindful of your thoughts. So not having negative thoughts to yourself, and then not having negative thoughts to other people. So not judging other people, not participating in gossip, not participating in rumor spreading and things like that, because what that does when you're gossiping about someone and you're talking, S-H-I-T, don't demonetize me, YouTube. When you're talking that about someone else, you're actually lowering your own vibration, because your words are things that you ingest, and you are ingesting everything that you put out and everything. And you should work on the problem that you have with yourself first before manifesting more of that problem by talking S-H-I-T about other people, or talking smack about other people, because that's going to lower your vibration a lot if you're constantly gossiping or talking negatively about other people. And again, that's another reason that dramatic things are so promoted in the media, because it lowers the collective vibration, it keeps them in a fearful state, it keeps them in a state where they feel powerless. And this is all about taking back our power, taking back our inherent worth as human beings, and reaching our truest and highest potential. So don't say anything that you wouldn't want to manifest. So if you hate someone and you don't want to manifest hate in your life, don't start speaking that you hate that person. All right, and that will definitely raise and help your auric field. That is one of the best things that you can do. And I get this question a lot about diets. What diet is the most highest vibrational, so to speak, and what diet is the best for you? I can't really say that I don't really have a solid answer to this, actually. I was vegan for 2 years, and it really started to deteriorate me. It was great in the beginning, but in terms of vitamins and minerals, they are very hard to find on a vegan diet. Personally, I ascribe to the belief that any diet that you have, it really doesn't matter as much as what your mental diet is and what you're putting into your brain and what you're thinking, what you're speaking, and what you're emotionally connected to, because I don't think that the diet actually affects it as much as we'd like to think. I'm walking way too far away. Okay. Anyway. How much money you have, how many cars you have, how many friends you have, none of that really relates to your vibration. Your vibration is different as an individual, and your vibration is ever changing. So it's changing with your thoughts. And the vibration of this planet is currently ascending. The Schumann resonance is actually increasing. There are studies by a group organization called HeartMath, which proves that our hearts are actually connected to the earth, and it shows how when there's fluctuations in the sun and when there's fluctuations in the planetary bodies, it actually affects a lot of the things that the masses do, and it affects how the masses interact with people. So it's kind of crazy to think that we aren't so separate from the earth and from other people's consciousness. So that's what I want to bring about on this video. I really want to hammer in the point that your auric field is always changing, that you're not necessarily low vibrational because you did any of these things on my list, but that you can help raise your spirit if you start to integrate and change your habits. And this is going to help so much with manifesting, using subliminals, using law of attraction techniques. Having a higher vibration is what it takes to be a happier person, to be in good health, and to be always having all of your chakras healthy and spinning and everything like that. So I hope that this video really helped you guys, and I hope that I was able to explain everything in a comprehensive and intelligent way. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, then I would be super, super grateful. My name is Megan, and this is Mrs. Megan X Rose, and I'll talk to you guys later.